Today I will read chapter number light, which is very important. So what do you mean by light and where we use light and what is the nature of light and what do you mean by reflection and what are the laws of reflection of light? So in this class, we will study these topics in detail. So what do you mean by light? Light is light is the form of energy visible. We will study light. So the word is sense of sight is one of the most important senses. As we know, because of our eyes, we can see everything. Through it, we see mountains, rivers, trees, plants, chairs, people, and so many other things around us. So many things which we see about rivers, mountains, people, so there, which we can see help of our eyes. See clouds, we also see rainbow and we are of eyes. We see the moon. With the help of eyes, we can see rainbow. And with the help of eyes, we can also see the birds flying in the sky. So at night, we see the moon and the star because of our eyes. You are able to see the words and sentence printed on this page. How is seeing made possible? So because of our eyes, we can see everything, but with our eyes, we also need light. Have you ever 16.1? What makes things visible? So कौन सी एक ऐसी चीज है जो things सारी चीजों को हमें visible बनाती है? And that is light. Because of light, we can see everything. Have you ever thought how we see various objects? You may say that I see the objects. As we discussed in the last passage, eyes help to see everything, but one thing more required, that is our light. So light is also needed for seeing objects. But can you see an object in the dark? No, we cannot see an object in the dark. It means that eyes alone cannot see an object. So for seeing an object, two things are required. First is our eyes and second is light. So you have to remember which things are required. First is eyes, second is light. Two things are required to see any objects. So which things are required to see any object? First is our eyes and second is light. So you have to to see things visible. First is our eyes and second is the first is eyes and second is light. It is only when light from an object enter our eyes, when in eyes our light enters, and with the help of these light we can see the object. The light may have been emitted by the object or may have reflected by us. So you have to remember, the light can be emitted by the object or may have reflected by it. So light हमारी कोई भी हो सकती है, या कोई object emit कर रहा है, या reflected light, whatever emitted light or reflected light. So with the help of these light, you learnt in class, face can act as a mirror. So this is a mirror and this is a poly surface, and this poly surface is made up of silver. So how can we make mirror? Suppose we are taking glass, and after this we are doing polish of silver. Why we are doing polish? Because silver is the best reflector of light. So with the help of this silver, we can make the mirror. As we discussed in the class 7th, that a polished or a shining surface can act as a mirror. And what is the purpose of mirror? A mirror changes the direction of light that falls on it. Suppose this is our mirror. This is surface and this is a poly surface. This is poly surface. And when light is incident on the mirror and after striking the mirror, in this mirror changes the direction of light. This mirror changes the direction of light. So what is the purpose of mirror? To change the direction of light. So you have to remember, what is the purpose of mirror? To change the direction of light. So what is the purpose of mirror? To change direction of light. So it is used for changing direction of light. So it is a purpose of mirror. And how can we make mirror? When a polished or shining surface act as a mirror, and on the glass we can do the polish of silver metal. So with the help of silver metal we can make mirror. And what is the purpose of mirror? To change the direction of light. Next topic is laws of reflection. So what do you mean by reflection? So you have to remember, so this is our mirror and this is the ray that falls on the mirror is incident ray, and after striking the mirror it changes the direction and it is called reflected ray. So suppose A, B is incident ray and BC is reflected ray. AB is incident ray and BC is reflected ray. So you have to remember what are the laws of reflection. So, and what do you mean by reflection? When the incident ray, after striking the mirror, it changes the direction, and this phenomena is called reflection of light. The phenomena of bending back of light when it strikes from the mirror is called reflection of light. So write down the definition of reflection of light. The phenomena of sending back of light when it strikes on a polished surface. So what are the laws of reflection? For reading the laws of reflection, firstly we will read the activity 16.1. And what is the activity 16.1? Fix a white sheet of paper on a drawing board on a table. Firstly, we will take a drawing board and then we will fix a white sheet of paper on the drawing board. So firstly, we will take a drawing board. As we know, this table, and on the table, we will put the drawing board, and then we will fix a white sheet of paper on this drawing board. Now, take a comb. So firstly, we will fix the white sheet of the white sheet on the table as shown in the figure. We will fix the white sheet on the table as shown in the figure. Then after this, what we are doing? After this, we are putting comb on the white sheet of paper. After this, we are putting comb and close its opening except one in the middle. So you close all these openings. जो भी इसकी lines है, जो comb की lines है, इसकी कुछ lining को छोड़ के इसको cover कर दो with the help of black paper. So how can we convert it? This is shown in the figure. 2-3 lines को छोड़ के बाकी जो lines है उसको हमने black paper से cover कर दिया. So with the help of black paper, we can cover the strip of the comb. Now, hold the comb perpendicular to the sheet of paper. Now, put this comb or perpendicular. Perpendicular means 90 degree to the sheet of paper. Throw light from a torch through the opening of the comb. So, how can we put light? So, we put light. So, now take a torch and then we throw light through these openings. Torch लेंगे और उसको torch की light को हम incident करेंगे जो हमारी इसमें openings हैं comb की जहाँ पे हमने black paper से cover नहीं किया. Then throw this light on this opening. So what we are observing? So next is throw light from a torch. This light adjustment of the torch and the comb, you will see a ray of light along the paper on the other side of the comb. So with the help of torch and the comb, what we are seeing? You will see a ray of light. So we see a ray of light along the paper on the another side of the comb. So in this figure, when we throw a torch light on the comb, what we are observing? A ray of light, a beam of light we are observing. Now keep the comb and the torch steady. Place a strip of plane mirror in the path of the light ray. Now put the plane mirror in the path of light. So now take a plane mirror as shown in the figure. So now take a plain mirror. Now when we throw the torch light on this comb, and then this incident on the mirror, and what is the purpose of this mirror? This mirror will change the direction of light as shown in the figure. This will convert all the incident ray into another direction as shown in the figure, and this is called reflection of light. So this is called reflection of light. So in the 15.16.1, so there is a plane mirror and we are showing the reflection. And what do you mean by reflection? Suppose any ray of light is incident on the mirror. Suppose any ray of light, suppose there is a light and which is incident on the mirror. And after striking this mirror, this changes the direction. So this is called reflection of light. So as is shown in the figure, this is the incident light. And after striking the mirror, it changes direction. And this phenomena is called reflection of light. So again, I am showing this activity. What is this activity? Firstly, we will take a table as shown in the figure. We will take a table, and then we will put some white sheets on this table. So firstly, we will take a table and we will put white sheet on this table. If table is not available, we can use drawing board. We can use drawing board if this table is not available. And after this, we will take a comb, and then we will put comb on this table. As shown in the figure, we will put this comb on the table. Now, next process is that we will close some openings of this comb with the help of black paper. Black paper से इसको हम जो भी इसके holes हैं उसको हम cover कर देंगे, 2-3 lines को छोड़ के बाकी holes को हम cover कर देंगे with the help of black paper. And after this, what we are observing, then we will throw torch light. As we are showing, we will throw the torch light on the comb. In the these holes, light enters, and light is entering in this hole, and we will get a beam of light. Then we will get a beam of light when light is incident on this comb. And after this, we will take a mirror. In this picture, a mirror is taken when light is incident on the mirror. And what is the purpose of this mirror? This mirror changes the direction. So this is incident light. This is incident light or incident ray. And after this is mirror. And after striking the mirror, it changes the direction. And this is called reflected ray. So this is called reflected ray. So this is the phenomena of reflection of light. So this is an activity to showing the reflection of light. So this is the phenomena of reflection of light. So in the figure 16.1, this is an arrangement for showing reflection of light in which we are using plane mirror. So note down the definition of incident ray. So what do you mean by incident ray? The ray that falls on the mirror. The light ray that falls on the mirror is called incident ray. And what do you mean by reflected ray? The ray that comes back from the surface after reflection is known as reflected ray. So you note down the definition of incident ray and reflected ray. So what do you mean by incident ray? The light ray which falls on the mirror. Suppose there is a mirror and the ray which falls on the mirror is called incident ray. And the mirror changes its direction, and after striking the mirror, the direction is changed and this ray is called reflected ray. So the ray that comes from the surface after reflection is called reflected ray. So you note down the definition of incident ray and reflected ray. And next is ray of light and beam of light. A ray of light is this. This is a single line with the arrow. This is ray of light. This is called ray of light with a single arrow. If there are so many arrows and so there are so many lines, this is called beam of light. This is called beam. So what is the difference between ray of light and beam of light? In a ray of light is a single line with arrow, and beam of light is a number of lines. A narrow beam of light is this is a single line, this is ray of light. And when there are so many lines, this is called beam of light. This is called beam of light. So this is beam of light. When single arrow is taken, this is ray. When there are so many arrows are taken, this is beam of light. And draw lines showing the position of the plane mirror. So this is our plane mirror, and with back polished surface, and we are drawing normal. And what do you mean by normal? So suppose this is our plane mirror and this is the incident ray. A ray which is perpendicular means 90 degree. A ray which is perpendicular to the mirror is called normal. So which is normal? So suppose this is a mirror, and the ray which is perpendicular to the mirror, jo mirror ki bilkul 90 degree pe hogi, this is called normal. So what do you mean normal? The ray which is perpendicular to the mirror. So the ray which is perpendicular to the mirror is called normal. Draw lines showing the position of the plane mirror, the incident ray and the reflected ray on the paper with the help of your friends. So we can draw the incident ray also. The ray which is perpendicular to the mirror is called normal. So you can draw a line making an angle of 90 degree to the mirror, and this is called normal. And what do you mean by angle of incidence? So suppose this is our plane mirror and this is incident. And this normal reflected ray, the angle between incident ray and normal, this is called angle of incidence. And the angle between normal and reflected ray is called angle of reflection. So what do you mean by angle of incidence? So the angle between normal angle between the normal and incident ray is called angle of incidence. And the angle between reflected ray and the normal is called angle of reflection. So what do we mean by angle incidence and what do we mean by angle of reflection? Angle between incident ray and normal is called angle of incidence. And the between reflected ray and normal is called angle of reflection. And what are the laws of reflection? Angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. So what do you mean by incident ray? Suppose this is our plane mirror and the ray is falling is called incident ray. And after reflection, it is reflected ray. Angle between incident ray and normal, it is called angle of incidence. And the angle between reflected ray and the normal is called angle of reflection. And what are the laws of reflection? Angle I is always equal to angle R. So this is law of reflection. Angle I is always equal to angle R. Angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. Suppose angle of incidence is taken 50 and what will be the angle of reflection? 50. If angle of incidence is 60, angle of reflection is 60. If this is 70, this is 70. If this is 80, this is also 80. Because angle I is equal to the angle of R. This is laws of reflection of light. So I am revising all the things. So which things are required to see things? First is our eyes and second is light. These two things are required to see any object. So these things are required to see any objects. And what do you mean by mirror? And what is the purpose of mirror? To change the direction of light. To change the direction of light, a mirror is used. And how can we make mirror? With the help of silver metal. On the plain glass, we do the polish of silver metal. And why we do the polish of silver metal? Because silver is the best reflector of light. Because silver is the best reflector of light. And what are the laws of reflection of light? Angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. And what is angle of incidence? What are reflected ray? The ray which falls on the mirror is called incident ray. And the ray that comes back from the surface after reflection is known as reflected ray. So what do you mean by incidence ray? The ray that falls on the mirror is called incident ray. AB is incident ray. The ray that comes out, it is called the reflected ray. So next is the normal angle of incidence and angle of reflection. And what do you mean by normal? Suppose it is our plane mirror, the line which is perpendicular to the mirror, it is called normal. This is our normal. The ray which is perpendicular to the mirror is called normal. So this is our normal. So this is our normal. This is our normal line. So what do you mean by normal? The line which is perpendicular to the surface is called normal. And what do you mean by angle of incidence? The angle between incident ray and normal is called angle of incidence. And the angle between reflected ray and the normal is called angle of reflection. So, and what are the laws of reflection? Angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. Angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. If angle is, incidence is 50, then what will be the angle of reflection? 50. If it is 60, then it will be 60, because it is always equal. Angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. Activity of reflection of light. Firstly, we will take white sheet of paper and then we will take comb and then we will cover these comb with the help of black paper and then we will put light and after it, it will strike the mirror and after striking the mirror, it changes the direction as shown in the figure and it is called reflection of light. So what do you mean by reflection of light? The process of sending back of light from a highly polished surface is called reflection of light. And what are the laws of reflection? Angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. So what do you mean by light? Light is a form of energy with the help of which we can see objects around us. So what do you mean by light? Light is a form of energy with the help of which we can see the objects around us. And what are the laws of reflection of light? Angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. And which is, what do you mean by normal? The rays which are perpendicular to the mirror is called normal. So the ray which is perpendicular to the mirror is called normal. So this is our normal. We are drawing a line perpendicular to the surface and it is called normal. And what do you mean by the angle of incidence? The angle between incident ray and normal is called angle of incidence. And the angle between reflected ray and the normal is called angle